I'd like to introduce the Wurlamin Language Project.
And we'll start with Iris Woods and Maureen Farmer going through a particular story, Tuatapulk.
Wurlamin Noongar Language and Stories, I think, came about largely was inspired by some work I was doing with Kayang Hazel Brown. We did a book together and we both started to realise what didn't fit in a book, and that was Indigenous language she carried.
With our ancient heritage, that is stories and sound embedded in place along the south coast here.
So we began trying to document that, particularly language and sight knowledge, and work on ways to consolidate that.
That's a joy for us, to reconnect story with the right sort of people, and with country, and with song, and share it.
Stories and the songs, the very sounds of some of our old language, I think, seems to work to strengthen and heal us, all of us.
The story's called Turut Balkan. It's about the dog and his head, and it changes. Turut Yonga, Jirangin, Dalangin, Bakanba, Ngaralangin, Nungataj,
The stories themselves are often archetypal, like many other ancient stories. They talk about language itself has a healing quality to it. They talk about the benefits of community, of brotherhood and sisterhood. Just in the business of learning the sounds of our ancestral language, we become instruments. We reshape ourselves from the inside out and become instruments for that language.
The dogs chased our Banimu, and it all happened the same way.
Indigenous language, languages and stories, songs, that heritage is a major denomination in the currency of identity and belonging.
We as a Wurlamin group are very happy and proud to be still alive and kicking, and love just sharing the language, our Noongar language and our stories and culture with each and every one of you.